This is my Banda drone. As you can see, it's been through a lot. It's scratched, shabby, it's in things. Is it ready for retirement? Not yet, but I figured maybe it's time to build a wingman. What's about? And here is the catch. I want this build to be made with high quality components. That's how I always try to build drones, with care and intention. So let's not waste any more time. I'll show you what I picked and why. Let's start with the frame, the heart of any build. My choice, the Era frame by IT’S FPV. Now listen, I have tried a lot of frames over the years, and I can tell you, picking the right one really matters. Frame stiffness affects your tuning, your flight feel, and straight crucial. If you fly Banda and crash a lot, your frame needs to hold up. Everything depends on it. This one, yeah, it's pricey, but from what I've seen online and based on my own experience, it is what we need. Solid, stiff, reliable. Motors. There is are from THobby, made in collaboration with IT’S FPV. To be honest, I had a few options, but these just spoke to me. The look, the size, the KV, 2306.5, 1750 KV, and this color, come on, it's beautiful, right? Now, electronics. Back in the day, I flew everything except Betafly. Race flight, keys, fat tech. Funny enough, most of my quads now run Betafly. It's really solid these days. But with this build, I'm going back to KISS. This is the KISS FCFC Ultra. Not new for me, but I'll need to refresh my memory with KISS GUI. You see, it's the VOLTARA plug and play with this FC. Never tried before, but I have got high hopes. For video, I'm going with DJI 04 Pro, no surprises there. Receiver is TBS Crossfire. I would love to run real RS, but in my case, I'm using the Tango 2. It's compact and I just love those low-resistant gimbals. Still haven't found anything that fits my style better, but hey, if one shows up, I'm open. And buzzer, what can I say, tiny, self-powered and instantly useful. So now it's time to build. I'll show you the main steps. Don't worry, I won't bore you with every single wire, shall we? So, like I said, it starts with the frame. The process isn't fast, but it's actually really fun, kind of like building a height stakes, like I said. If you go with the same frame, there is a full build guide on the official website, but I want to highlight a few things. That center looking arm element, sure, not new idea, but this front section, the canopy housing, it's clearer. It's hold the FPV cam, acts as a bumper and even as a base for the action cam. Also, check this out, the standoffs are kind of integrated into the design, like it. Next, I'm installing the motors, nothing special over here, but if you're new to this, one tip, use Loctite. It helps to keep screws in place, especially with vibrations or even micro nano vibrations. Now we are adding the VTX system. It's best to do it now because the wires between the camera and the VTX module runs under the other components. Easier to route it before the stack, isn't it? Speaking of the stack, have a look. I'm not using the long screw that comes with the frame. Instead, I'm following the manufacturer's advice for this specific electronics combo. I mean, shorter screws. EC goes first, then soft dampers and the flight control on the top. I just assembled it to show you. Now I'll take the FC off, we'll get back to it later. And it's time to solder. We start with the power wires. I'm using 14AWG. It is more than enough for S6's build. Next, the capacitor. I'm using one that came with the EC. Usually the minus is marked with this stripe or something, but in this case, this colored part marks the negative side. The other leg is the positive, obviously. Carefully route the wires, measure the lead and cut off the excess. Don't leave any extra lead, but also be careful not to cut too short. Then we tin the ends, preparing them for soldering. Of course, tin the EC parts too. Little advice, preheat them if the solder doesn't want to stick. Little trick that helps a lot. And now, motor soldered.
that's a big step down. Now we connect the ESC to the ETH using the cable, stick it up. Sure, I could use the connector for the video system, but I'm following the recommended way, soldering power directly to the flight controller and video signal separately TX6 and RX6. Crossfire or LRS, install the receiver. That part's pretty straightforward. I'm also installing and soldering the buzzer. Personally, I prefer the self-powered ones. It's extremely important for me. I have lost a couple of drones. Okay, that's the build done. But before we move on, a few extra thoughts I didn't say during the assembly process. First off, this frame was a joy to build. Everything fits perfectly, super clean. Honestly, it's easier to assemble than the Apex. And dare I say it, it feels stiffer too. I know, bold claim, but hey, that's just my impression. Second, there is plenty of space. The capacitor, buzzer, receiver all fit nicely into this mount section. Clean layout, nothing overcrowded, that's a win. But right now, it's just carbon and components. Time to set it up. Alright, let's plug in the drone and do a quick walkthrough in the KISS GUI. We're using the browser version, connect, select the COM port, hit connect. Right away, it prompts us to update the flight control firmware. Two options, local or remote firmware. We'll go with the latest remote version, click download, then flash firmware. And yeah, this will take a minute. Once it's done, reconnect and activate the FC. Oh, interesting. It's offering recommended settings for best performance. I've flown a similar setup before, so I'll give this a shot and compare them to my usual tune later. Let's see what they come up with. Quick run through. Quad X, default mapping, TBS Crossfire, TAER. There are a few presets here. I will compare them with what I have used on my nearly identical build. Alright. Let's go with it and see how it flies. One thing I will change right away, the rates. The stock ones just don't work for me. I put it in mile. Save that. Now switch setup. I set R, level, AUX 3 for buzzer, and turtle mode. In the advanced tab, I enable launch mode, check reverse motor, and under the serial 6, which is our video link, I select MSP OSD. Make sure to select your video system here so the USD shows up properly. In the data output tab, you can see your channel map. We will come back to this later. Then the OSD tab for configuring what you want to see in your goggles. And finally, the ESC flasher. Yeah, this is where we update the ESC firmware. It's pretty much the same process as with the FC. Download the latest firmware and flash it. Once done, reconnect again. Back in that output, you can now test the motors and verify their spin direction. Step by step. If anything spinning the wrong way, just go to the ESC flasher, change direction and hit save. In my case, that's motors 1 and 2.
That's it. Probably the easiest build I've ever done. But we are not done without a test flight. Thank you.
guys, this is a very fast park, it means nothing crazy. I have to say, it flies really, really well. Actually, it flies great. If I had to sum it up in a nutshell, easy to assemble, easy to tune, and flies just great. This is my hot take.